Hurricanes, one of Earth's most powerful storms, still contain many mysteries and what powers them. NASA is investigating these mysteries, such as what affects the intensity of hurricanes. Right now, NASA employs several Earth-observing satellites with instruments suited to studying hurricanes from space. NASA also flies missions into hurricanes, such as the 5-year Hurricane Severe Storm Sentinel, or HS3 mission. Tropical Storm Narelle, January 15, 2013, was observed using the AERS instrument aboard the Aqua satellite. The images taken over 6 days show the progression of Narelle becoming a cyclone, then back to a weaker tropical storm. The purple areas, located towards the center of the storm, indicate the coldest cloud top temperatures. Colder clouds are associated with heavier rainfall. These images, taken by the MODIS instrument on Aqua, present images just 2 days apart that show the deformation of Tropical Storm Narelle. On January 13th, the eye became cloud-filled, indicating the storm slowing down. Hurricane Rita, September 19th, 2005. The focus of this visualization is the hot towers that appear through the precipitation radar on the satellite TRIM. The red areas within the hurricane indicate the highest rainfall intensity, which generally occurs within tall cumulonimbus clouds. The towers release heat from condensation, which in turn power the intensity of the storm. The 18-kilometer towers located in the eye wall indicated that Rita was intensifying. Rita was categorized as a Category 4 hurricane within 2 days of this data from TRIM. The HS3 program employs two unmanned Global Hawks with the unique capabilities to fly directly into hurricanes. One of the aircraft uses instruments geared towards investigating the inner structure of hurricanes. The second aircraft monitors the surrounding environment of the hurricane. The Hurricane and Severe Storm Sentinel mission is responsible for investigating the processes behind hurricane formation and intensity change. Right now, the mission's investigating the influence of the Saharan air layer and the effect it has upon storm formation. The HS3 mission is also studying hot towers within hurricanes, such as the towers within Hurricane Rita. Data are currently suggesting that when hot towers are present in a hurricane, it will increase in intensity within 6 hours. NASA's HS3 mission is seeking answers to questions that are not obtainable by satellites, such as the rapid intensification of hurricanes. NASA will continue to research hurricanes using satellites, aircraft, field missions, and visualizations, and more, to gain better insight into the workings of them. Follow NASA updates on the NASA Hurricane webpage at nasa.gov/hurricanes.